this state that in these weeks is with inhuman ferocity demolishing the first and unique houses of need of the poor people in an island as Ischia, where the town planning laws don't allow the ordinary mortals not even to open a new window in an old apartment building of which one cannot even to expand a small room of the kitchen, shamefully continues to destroy part of the green pinewood Bosco della Maddalena to build a big building on reinforced concrete of 3 floors to implement the new forest barracks of that institution that should protect our wood heritage and not destroying it. As news, remember that just the public prosecutor of Naples, who in these weeks, without wanting to listen to any reason, is demolishing the houses of poor people forced to build abusively by the defaulting state. In this pine wood, in recent months, has unfrozen the yard, giving the go-ahead for the absurd and tolerable state-building ruin. And the majority of intervention have focused just about the incredible contradiction between demolitions of dwelling houses and the current state massacre. We as committee cannot accept that on the one hand we are demolished and on the other have realized these massacres. Then I can say that the justification of the town administration are childish. In short, they are not neutral. We know well the particular because we live here since 1978, and then we know well the history of the particulars. I can say that given the inertia of the Italian state, we are determined to go to Brussels. Now we have understood that here in Italy the laws are valid only for us, and therefore it is appropriate to bypass this state which does not protect us, and then we will go and see other glories. Well, we are describing an incredible paradox. While the judiciary is moving forward in an uncompromising manner, without agreeing any recurrence in demolishing the houses of poor people, that same Neapolitan judiciary here inside the Pinewood Bosco della Maddalena a few weeks ago has unfrozen the yard, giving the start, giving the opportunity to state to destroy part of this green land to build the state forest barracks, that institution which in Italy is delegated or should be delegated to defend our environmental heritage, and instead come to destroy a part of it for constituting from scratch the building of 3 floors in reinforced concrete. The suites of our father, the house, what do allow it us to do? Capitals? Surely you find capitals in the bank. The Ischitans don't have capitals in bank. They built a house and offended the world building the house that owned with the state was to give them, this infamous state which does not recognize that these ones have his sons, and he must be a father to these citizens of the island of Ischia. Long and passionate has been the speech of Domenico Savio, Secretary General of the Italian Marxist-Leninist Communist Party, who, about 10 years with his party, is fighting against the destruction of the Pinewood Bosco della Maddalena. Why we are faced with so much social injustice? It is the arrogance, the dictatorship of the state that, while on the other hand destroys the homes of the poor, on the other hand builds an eco-monster in reinforced concrete. A state that, doing in this way, says, I am in command and I do what I want. Well, this state, citizens, is not our state, because this state does not represent the rights of the people of the community. Unfortunately, even here this morning, I must repeat that this state, with its political power, is not an abstract entity that someone has sent us from heaven as misfortune. It is a state of misfortune. It's an unfortunate political power, but it is a state of misfortune and is an unfortunate political power that unfortunately all of you, with your political behaviors, have helped to set up. As leader of my party, we can say that I was the first to organize a social and political battle against the creation of this eco-monster by the state. My first statement was in 2004, if I remember. During these years, I presented 3 statements to the public prosecutors of Naples and to the other institutions that had the possibility to stop the shame of state. 3 statements and an appeal to the President of the Republic, even though I never did devote myself, because I remember that this President had signed a few days ago that decree of the government that accept again some electoral role, should accept again some electoral goals of center-right in the regions of Lazio and Lombardy, a decree that tramples the Italian electoral law only because this government believes to be above all, in the same manner as the state has moved like a tank with this eco-monster that is building here behind us. Domenico Savio, at the conclusion of his speech, has attacked at point blank the Minister Mara Carfagna, who, like other candidates in the upcoming regional election, only in these days seemed to have noticed the drama of the demolition. What a coincidence! She noticed it now that must take votes. But what a strange coincidence! We must break with this power. They know what it is about and must give us only the decree which we ask to stop our demolition. Other than answering the call of Carfagna, of Davide Conte and of other candidates who bring votes of our island, other than going to the invitation to be told, we are moving, we will see the Council of Ministers, the bill, if we are elected to lead the region, dear citizen. I talk on the same plan, either of the center-right and the false left of center-left. Dear citizen, don't be fooled falsely even this time. Aid the courage to these candidates, these vote hunters, to throw them literally and politically out from your homes. This is people who does not deserve any more the trust, the support, the vote of citizens. One thing is certain, although the works of destruction of our beautiful Pinewood proceed quietly, we will continue with strength and courage to fight against the shameful and intolerable slaughter of state that still does not find space, despite our insistent demands on the national mass media. National press and televisions that, while on the one hand are always ready to eat out over the poor bastards to which is demolition the only and first home of need, on the other hand, when who makes building slaughters is the state, entrenches itself behind an absurd and conspiracy silence.